is the beginning of Handel's Dixit Dominus, which we are so thrilled to be presenting at the Hills Church as part of our special Music Sunday, this coming Sunday, December 10th at 10 a.m. Dixit Dominus is the Latin translation of Psalm 110, which has often been interpreted as a messianic prophecy about the coming of a priest king who will usher in the kingdom of God, challenge the powers of the world, and restore justice. Handel wrote this piece when he was at the ripe age of 22. And he was traveling through Italy and absorbing and learning the latest Italian styles of vocal and instrumental writing from such composers as Vivaldi and Corelli. It's a work that's full of youthful exuberance, daring experimentation, and full of variety and expression. Our chancel choir has been working incredibly hard on this piece. Our soloists have been learning the beautiful arias, and we will have a wonderful Baroque orchestra playing on period instruments. So please tell your friends and neighbors and join us this coming Sunday, December 10th at 10 a.m. for Special Music Sunday and Handel's wonderful Dixit Dominus. Hope to see you there. is the beginning of Handel's Dixit Dominus, which we are so thrilled to be presenting at the Hills Church as part of our special Music Sunday, this coming Sunday, December 10th at 10 a.m. Dixit Dominus is the Latin translation of Psalm 110, which has often been interpreted as a messianic prophecy about the coming of a priest king who will usher in the kingdom of God, challenge the powers of the world, and restore justice. Handel wrote this piece when he was at the ripe age of 22, and he was traveling through Italy and absorbing and learning the latest Italian styles of vocal and instrumental writing from such composers as Vivaldi and Corelli. It's a work that's full of youthful exuberance, daring experimentation, and full of variety and expression. Our chancel choir has been working incredibly hard on this piece. Our soloists have been learning the beautiful arias, and we will have a wonderful Baroque orchestra playing on period instruments. So please tell your friends and neighbors and join us this coming Sunday, December 10th at 10 a.m. for Special Music Sunday and Handel's wonderful Dixit Dominus. Hope to see you there. Thank you.
invited now to rise in either body or spirit as you are able and join me. How beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of the messenger who announces peace. Let us now come before God as we are, knowing that God will protect us, give us strength and love. Will you join me in the unison prayer of confession as printed? Gracious God, who promised to send a Redeemer to your people, we confess that we have not trusted your promise, but have busied ourselves with activities which obstruct its fulfillment. We give the mercy of God is unending. The love of God is all-encompassing, and the peace we share in Christ is fathomless. Knowing this, knowing that we are forgiven today and all days, thanks be to God. It is in this spirit of gratitude for God's unending mercy and love that I invite you to recall the words of Jesus, quoting Scripture, telling us just how we are to live. Hear, O Israel, the Lord your God, the Lord is one. And you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. This is the first and the greatest commandment, and the second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no law which is greater than these. You may be seated. And as you are sitting, I invite up Chris Weinman and John Bradica to be our Advent liturgists this morning. And as they come forward, I invite the children to come up a little closer if they can. Right? Maybe we can scoop between Reverend Jonathan, and maybe we can sit up here next to Dr. Will Cooper. Front row seat to the bringing of the light of peace. Very good. And after the candle is lit and the music begins, then you will be able to go upstairs with Mrs. T. But wait until that moment, okay? Okay, good.
From Isaiah chapter 40, verses 1 through 5. Comfort, O comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem, and cry to her that she has served her term, that her penalty is paid, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries out, in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make straight the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken.
Good morning. We'd like to offer a meditation. Peace is a blessing from God. We share that peace each Sunday here in church. We cherish harmony with God and one another. We know such harmony requires acceptance and love. Jesus, the Prince of Peace, reminds us of the challenges that come with keeping harmony. He teaches us to love each other humbly, to accept those we love as they are and for who they are. We sadly often fall quite far from peace. Nations are at war. We hold hatred in our hearts for those who differ from us. Sometimes a hard day's frustrations cause us to hurt our loved ones. But each Advent season, when we wish once more for peace on earth, and goodwill toward men and women, we show to God our yearning to be deserving of his blessings. May God grant us the wisdom, strength, and love to do so. And now the candle of peace.
Please pray with me. Holy God, our hope and strength, by the power of your Spirit, prepare the way in our hearts for the coming of your word, so that we may see the glorious signs of your promise fulfilled. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our reading comes from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 1, beginning with the first verse. The beginning of the good news of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. As it is written in the prophet Isaiah, "See, I am sending my messenger ahead of you who will prepare your way. The voice of one crying out in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight." John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And the people of the whole Judea countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to him and were baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair, with a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locust and wild honey. He proclaimed, "The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down until untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." This is the good news.
Good morning. We want to welcome you all to the Wellesley Hills Congregational Church this morning, and we also welcome all of you who are out there in streaming land. We're grateful to the Holy Spirit and to technology bringing us together in this one household of God's love. And we're also grateful to Baroque instruments from another time and place. At this time, if you could fish around in your pews and find the fellowship pads, they should be in there, and we hope that you will give us the splendid opportunity to know who is here today and to share your name. And if we can give you any more information about the church, we will be delighted to do so. And those of you who are out there in streaming land, if you can send me an email at some point and say, "I'm here," that makes me very happy. So judy@hillschurch.org. We rejoice in the special music we'll be hearing in a moment. And it's not just today, but several times in the next few weeks. Yes, on Wednesday, December 13th at 11 a.m., we welcome all back to the sanctuary where Dr. Will Cooper, Lori Otten, and Michael Calmes will be offering a special Christmas concert. And what could even make music better? Food. The seniors ministry team offers a luncheon immediately after the concert, but you have to sign up for that. So if you'd like to attend that luncheon, please RSVP with me or Susan Walton or Andrea in the office by tomorrow. Next Saturday, Christmas with Cookies with Santa will be happening at 9 a.m. And then more music, a Christmas concert at 4 o'clock here in the sanctuary. Yes, so go shopping early. Then come relax and enjoy the music. But wait, there's more. Next Sunday, our Joy Sunday, the pink candle, there will be a celebration of Reverend Anne-Marie Holloway's ministry with us for the past 5 years. Anne-Marie will be preaching, and there after the service will be a terrific reception in her honor. Christmas is coming, and on Christmas Eve, which is a Sunday, there are three services, count them, 3:30, a family pageant, 6 o'clock, a candlelight service where all these beautiful candelabra will be lit, and a 10 p.m. candlelight service with communion. But note, on that Sunday, no 10 a.m. service, so you can sleep or wrap your presents. Also, folks tell me to tell everyone that annual reports are due. This is a congregational church, after all. We have to know what each other's doing. And you get prizes, the briefer, the better. Sue Spencer reports, this Christmas report, the Christmas gift ministry has been a huge success, thanks to everybody. This is amazing, folks. 338 children and adults will get presents this year because of all of you. 91 families, 77 shoppers, $6,300 in gift cards and donations. Everyone will receive gifts for Christmas. And a little PS, Honduras Hope baskets are also for sale under at the coffee hour. So, deep breath. We know that you will all be wanting to share your appreciation for special music this morning. And we want to allow lots of good time for Handel, so the ushers will not be circulating the plate to collect the offerings this morning during the service. But immediately after the service, the ushers will be in the exits with collection plates. And so we ask that you offer your donation in the specific envelope, or you can write a message on a check line, or you can go electronic and use Zelle and use the QR code if you love to do that. So you have lots and lots of options to show your appreciation. And as I said, this is the way we're going to handle donations to the music fund. All right, you got it? And ushers, you all understand what you've got to do? I hope so. All right. And now, remembering the words of Jesus, it is more blessed to give than to receive. Let us give thanks. Generous and gracious God, we praise you for the gift of music, the talents of the choir, musicians, conductor, and composer. Now receive and bless these gifts, and may all our offerings support your holy work. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you. And now let us pray. O God in heaven, as once again we prepare for Christmas, help us to find time in our busy lives for quiet and thought and prayer, that we may reflect upon the wonder of your love and allow the story of the Savior's birth to penetrate our hearts and minds. So may our joy be deeper, our worship more real, and our lives worthier of all that you have done through us, through the coming of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now, as Christ our Lord has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And now I'd ask you to please join me as we express our appreciation and thanks for all the hard work of the chancel choir, the musicians here, and especially Dr. Will Cooper. Will has some special acknowledgments and thanks that he'd like to present.
Thank you so much. I'd like to once again thank these wonderful musicians up here. Can we have another round of applause for our players? Would all of our soloists, vocal soloists, stand up? And the wonderful Hills Church Chancel Choir. This in the program notes, but this is the most difficult vocal work of Handel, and they just tackle the challenge, put in so much time and hard work, and I really appreciate them. And I'd like to also thank two people in particular, Shannon and Garrett. Would you both stand? So Shannon and Garrett, yes, please. Shannon and Garrett are both longtime soloist section leaders at Hills Church. I believe Shannon has been the soloist since 2007, and Garrett since 2014. And it's really sad to me that they are both moving on at the end of December. Fortunately, they will both be here for the next two weekends, and they've assured me that they'll come back to substitute. So we'll see them again, but I've only been able to enjoy a sliver of that time with them, but in the 4 months that I've been here, it has been such a thrill and a privilege to work with both of these amazing singers. So Shannon and Garrett, we're really going to miss you, and we wish you best of luck, and please take time to thank them personally after the service. So can we have one more round of applause for Shannon and Garrett? And one, can we just express our appreciation one more time for these just incredible players, singers, everybody.
spread that joy with others. And now may the peace which passes all understanding keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ. And may the blessing of the God who created you, the God who redeemed you, and the God who sustains you with an ever-loving spirit be with you this day and remain with you always.